Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' physics.
Ladies and gentlemen, people, the bell has rung, therefore class has begun, therefore you should be seated in your seats ready and excited to learn the difference between instantaneous and average.
Instantaneous.
Average. They look the same to me.
Very nice. We're going to learn the difference between instantaneous and average by way of the term velocity. So we have instantaneous velocity and average velocity. Instantaneous velocity is the velocity at a specific point in time, while average velocity is the velocity over a time period. So we have instantaneous velocity, which is a velocity at a specific point in time, and we have average velocity, which is a velocity over a time period or a time duration. Now, we've actually already had examples of these two different kinds of velocity, we just haven't identified them as such. For example, in your uniformly accelerated motion equations, there are two velocities, velocity final and velocity initial. Bobby, are velocity final and velocity initial in your UAM equations, are those instantaneous or average velocities?
Let's see. Final velocity would be the velocity at the final point, which is, that's a specific point in time. Therefore, it must be an instantaneous velocity. And the same thing is true for the initial velocity. They're both instantaneous velocities.
Correct. The two variables, velocity final and velocity initial, from our UAM equations are instantaneous velocities because they're velocities at specific points in time, that final point and that initial point. Bo, what is the equation we know for velocity?
Velocity equals displacement over time.
Actually, it's over change in time.
Yeah, change in time. And because it's change in time, that is a time duration, a time period. So velocity equals displacement over change in time. That's an equation for average velocity.
Great, so you can see we've actually already been working with instantaneous and average velocities. Now we're gonna take a look at a graph and talk more about them using the graph. We have our position as a function of time graph, position in meters, time in seconds. We have on our position axis 2.0 meters and 7.0 meters. On our time axis, we have 5.0, 10.0, and 17.0 seconds. The blue line indicates the motion of the object. Janine, could you please be our object this time? Could you please walk the graph for us so we can see what it looks like?
Sure, Dad. Start.
Thanks, Janine. Now I'm going to ask several questions. We're going to figure out some stuff about this graph, which will help us to understand the difference between instantaneous and average velocity. First, what is the velocity from 0 to 5 seconds? Now, Billy, when I ask for the velocity from 0 to 5 seconds, am I asking for an instantaneous velocity or an average velocity?
Well, because you're asking it for from 0 to 5 seconds, it must be an average velocity, because from 0 to 5 seconds, that's a time period.
Yes, therefore we need to use the equation for average velocity, which is change of position over change in time. And we know that delta always means final minus initial. Therefore, on the top we get position final minus position initial. On the bottom we end up with time final minus time initial. And then we know that our final position is 5 seconds and our initial position was 0 seconds. Therefore, it works out to be the position at 5 seconds minus the position at 0 seconds divided by the time at 5 seconds minus the time at 0 seconds. Bo, could you please look at the graph and fill in the numbers for me?
Let's see. According to the graph, the position at 5 seconds is 2 meters and the position at 0 seconds is also 2 meters. And the time at 5 seconds is 5 seconds and the time at 0 seconds is 0 seconds. So we get 0/5, which is just 0. So the average velocity from 0 to 5 seconds is 0.
Yes, the average velocity from 0 to 5 seconds works out to be 0. This is how you would solve it mathematically. But the truth is you should be able to look at the graph and know that the average velocity from 0 to 5 seconds is 0. Who can tell me how?
Because of the slope of the line.
Because
of the slope of the
line. Go ahead, Billy.
Thanks, Bo. Because if you watch the video or look at the graph, you can see that Genevieve doesn't move for the first 5 seconds, and when someone isn't moving, their velocity is zero.
Yes, Billy, that's absolutely correct. There are other ways of looking at it, though. So, Bobby, what were you going to say?
The line is horizontal from 0 to 5 seconds. The slope of a horizontal line is zero, and the slope of a position versus time graph is velocity. Therefore, her average velocity from 0 to 5 seconds must be zero.
Great. Both answers are correct. Let's move on and let's look at the velocity from 5 to 10 seconds. So Billy, could you please figure out the velocity from 5 to 10 seconds? And while you do so, could you please tell me whether you're figuring out an instantaneous or average velocity?
Well, again, 5 to 10 seconds is a time duration, so you're asking for an average velocity. So we use the equation velocity equals change in position over change in time. We know both of those are final minus initial. The final is at 10 seconds and the initial is at 5 seconds. So we get the position at 10 seconds minus the position at 5 seconds over the time at 10 seconds minus the time at 5 seconds. Reading the numbers off the graph, that works out to be the position at 10 seconds is 7 meters minus the position at 5 seconds, which is 2 meters, divided by 10 seconds minus 5 seconds. So we get 5 over 5, which is 1, and with 2 sig figs, we get 1.0 meters per second. The average velocity from 5 to 10 seconds is 1.0 meters per second.
Very nice. So far, we figured out the average velocity from 0 to 5 seconds is 0, and we figured out the average velocity from 5 to 10 seconds is 1.0 meters per second. Bobby, what is the velocity at 7 seconds?
That would be 1.0 meters per second.
And how do we know?
Because the slope of a position versus time graph, again, is velocity, and the slope of the line at 7 seconds is 1.0 meters per second.
And Bo, is the velocity of 1.0 meters per second at 7 seconds, is that an instantaneous or an average velocity?
Instantaneous velocity, because it's at the specific time of 7 seconds.
Good. Bobby, what is the instantaneous velocity at 9 seconds?
Also 1.0 meters per second.
Yes, and Bo, what is the instantaneous velocity at 6.9723416 seconds?
Still 1.0 meters per second.
Yes, so notice that the average velocity from 5 to 10 seconds is the same as the instantaneous velocity at any point between 5 and 10 seconds. One word of caution, this is not always true. Let's go through another example. We're going to figure out the velocity, the average velocity from 0 to 17 seconds. Because it's slightly redundant, I'll go through and do it this time. The average velocity from 0 to 17 seconds. We're going to use the equation for average velocity, change in position over change in time. Delta change in is always final minus initial. Final is 17 seconds, initial is 0 seconds. Therefore, we have the position at 17 seconds minus the position at 0 seconds divided by the time at 17 seconds minus the time at 0 seconds. That works out to be 7, the final position, minus 2, the initial position, divided by 17, the final time, minus 0, the initial time. That works out to be 5/17, or 0.29412, with 2 sig figs, 0.29 meters per second, the average velocity from 0 to 17 seconds. Billy, how could we illustrate this average velocity on the graph?
I don't know. How can you show the average velocity for the whole event on the graph? Oh, that would be the slope of a line that goes from 0 to 17 seconds.
Yes. The slope of this dotted red line is 0.29 meters per second, and it represents the average velocity from 0 to 17 seconds, or the average velocity for the whole trip. Bo, according to our graph, was Genevieve's instantaneous velocity ever equal to her average velocity for the whole trip?
It must have been.
Be careful, Bo. Listen to the question. According to our graph, was Genevieve's instantaneous velocity ever equal to her average velocity for the whole trip?
Oh, I get it. The answer is, according to our graph, she only had instantaneous velocities of either 0 or 1.0 meters per second, and therefore, no. Her instantaneous velocity was never 0.29 meters per second. However, that's not possible.
Yes, remember our graph represents ideal data, which means at any point between 0 and 5 seconds, at any point between 10 and 17 seconds, her instantaneous velocity was always equal to 0. At any point between 5 and 10 seconds, her instantaneous velocity was always equal to 1.0 meters per second, which means her instantaneous velocity was either 0 or 1. It was never equal to 0.29 meters per second, which was the average velocity for the whole trip, because this is ideal data. But Bolt pointed out that this is actually not possible, which is correct. In order to understand why it's not possible, I ask this question. What was Genevieve's instantaneous velocity at exactly 5 seconds? You guys are all correct. Turns out that the velocity at 5 seconds is undefined. The reason for that is because the slope at 5 seconds is undefined, therefore you're gonna have an undefined instantaneous velocity at that point, which is not possible. A real object can't have an undefined instantaneous velocity. Genevieve, in reality, had to accelerate from 0 to 1 meter per second, and then she had to decelerate from 1 meter per second down to 0. Therefore, there should be curves at this point if we're talking about a real object, and those curves would look like this. However, these curves mathematically are pretty difficult to deal with, and that math is really outside the scope of this class. So in this class, we're really only going to deal with ideal data. It's a good approximation of reality, but it's not perfect. Any questions?
Nope.
No, thanks.
Not yet. In that case, let's do a quick review of the stuff we learned today. Instantaneous velocity is the velocity at a specific point in time. For example, velocity final and velocity initial in our uniformly accelerated motion equations are instantaneous velocities. We also know that average velocity is the velocity over a time period or a time duration. The equation, therefore, is velocity equals change of position over change in time. We used a graph to show that when you have a constant slope, the average velocity and the instantaneous velocity are going to be the same. However, when the slope changes, for example, all the way from the beginning to the end, we had a change in the slope. Therefore, the average velocity was not going to be equal to the instantaneous velocity. Ladies and gentlemen, people, I hope you enjoyed learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.
Lecture notes are available at flippingphysics.com. Please enjoy lecture notes responsibly. Ooh, 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 ooh.